It's a political campaign ad ripped from the headlines. In this case, a headline created by Republican gubernatorial candidate Bob Ehrlich. Last week, Mr. Ehrlich generated news after accusing Governor O'Malley's campaign of a cover-up.
He also charged the governor used a state agency to deceive Maryland residents for his own political gain. And now Ehrlich is using that same accusation in a new attack ad. 11 News I-Team reporter David Collins is live in the studio with us with a commitment 2010 fact check. David?
Stan, Bob Ehrlich's latest political TV ad alleges the O'Malley administration orchestrated the cover-up of a gloomy jobs report inadvertently posted on a state website. What's missing is evidence of a cover-up, and the spot doesn't make the case that the governor was actually involved.
Job loss.
Republican Bob Ehrlich released emails last week his campaign obtained through a Public Information Act request to support his claim that Governor O'Malley used the state Labor Department for his own political gain. The emails reveal that a senior member of the O'Malley administration ordered a bleak assessment of the state's economy be removed from a state website and replaced with a more positive assessment. Ehrlich has now turned the headlines he generated with this accusation into a new political attack ad, claiming the event amounts to a cover-up.
O'Malley attempts a cover-up, falsifying the jobs report to help his campaign.
This is false. The report was mistakenly posted August 20th by an employee with the Department of Labor, Licensing, and Regulation. Department officials characterized it as talking points designed to launch an internal discussion about how the numbers should be presented. The numbers in the report never changed. The ad wants you to believe that someone doctored the report. The fact is, what the Ehrlich camp blots out in red ink is a Department of Labor analyst's explanation of those numbers.
Whatever we can do to make it disappear, we need to do it. That's coming straight from the top.
This is true, but the emails do point to a scramble by Labor Department officials to remove what they called this outrageous material, not only from the state webpage, but the internet as well. But the order to remove the gloomy economic report came from State Labor Secretary Alex Sanchez, not Governor O'Malley. The governor told reporters he wasn't aware of the episode and didn't believe he had seen the report. The emails released by the Ehrlich campaign even explains that the quote, "that's coming straight from the top," refers to Labor Secretary Sanchez. Labor Communications Director Bernie Cohn writes, "At Secretary Sanchez's direction, I instructed Michelle to take it down. She did so."
Martin O'Malley. First he makes stuff up. When caught, he covers stuff up.
This is false. If, in fact, this claim is in reference to the emails and the Department of Labor posting, they offer no evidence that the governor was involved.
Last week, State House Republicans formally requested that a legislative committee be formed to investigate the circumstances surrounding the removal of the July jobs report. Meanwhile, the ad comes on the heels of yet another new poll. According to the Republican-leading Rasmussen reports, O'Malley has an 8-point advantage over Ehrlich. A Washington Post survey last week gave O'Malley an 11-point lead. Reporting live from the studio, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.